Good day, everybody. In this video, I would like to explain how we can estimate change in the vertical stress when we apply horizontal load to the soil mass. Let's look at this schematic diagram. So here we have a soil element, and at this point, we are going to apply horizontal load. It's kind of a line load, just imagine a brick wall. So we would like to know what is going to be the stress, and this is going to be Q. So let's assume that in this example, Q will be equal to 5 kilonewton per square meters. And then we need to know the depth of the soil element, which is Z. So in this case, Z will be, let's assume 4 meters, just for this example. And we would like to also know the distance. The distance will be called X. And let's assume that X is 5 meters. So this is what we're going to find, change in the vertical stress due to the load application. This is the equation that we can use to solve the problem. Remember that this equation works for homogeneous, elastic, and isotropic medium, which in real life soil typically is not. But when we apply very small loads, so in this case, we can still assume that soil mass can be to some extent homogeneous, elastic, and isotropic. Another solution is involving the use of this graph, and I will explain it later. Let's first start with the formula. And what I'm gonna do just to put numbers in the formula to estimate change in the vertical stress. So we need to know the Q. So we assume it's 5 kilonewton per square meters. Then we're going to divide by the pi. I'm going to use 3.14159. I think that should be enough. Then we're going to multiply by the x in the power of 2. So it will be 5 in the power of 2 times z, which is the depth for meters. And divide by, I put here 5 in the power of 2 plus 4 in the power of 2, and everything is in the power of 2. According to my calculations, the answer will be 0.189 kilonewton per square meter. So that will be the change in the vertical stress here at this depth. Let's now see how we can use this graphical solution. So we're not going to use the formula anymore. We're just going to use this plot. I plotted it as x over z. And on this axis, we have delta sigma z. So that's what we need to find, divided by q over z. So first, we need to calculate x over z. So x is 5 meters, z is 4 meters, is going to give us 1.25. So now we're going to see where we have 1.25. It will be this point. And then see where it's on the curve. Somewhere here in the middle. So 1.24. So according to my estimation, it should be 0.15, approximately 0.15. So we can now rewrite that change in the vertical stress. Here we have Q, which is 5. Z, we have 4 meters. And this should be equal to 0.15, right? So in this case, change in the vertical stress, it's 0.15 times 5 over 4, it's 1.25. So that will give us approximately 0.188, which is very similar to this answer. Of course, we shouldn't forget to write units, kilonewton per square meters. So that's two ways to solve this, just using the formula or just using this graph. Either way is fine, just decide by yourself which one you're going to use. That's it for this tutorial. Thanks for watching it. Have a nice day. Bye.